so many chat right now, so many messages as hello ma'am, you are my favorite ma'am, and how are you? So I really want to give all the answers. I'm really very happy and excited right now, and I'm very healthy and fit and fine. So thank you so much for asking me this question. I think it's a beautiful question for my side, that how are you? Yeah, it's an important question. It's a beautiful question. So thank you so much for asking this question. I'm perfectly fine and very, very, very happy and excited to see you all. And thank you so much for lots of appreciation. So thank you. Okay, so let's start. Ma'am already told you all about the class, so I'm just going to quickly tell you some points which are very important, that whenever you are done with any step or you understood this step, or so you have to show me thumbs up like this, or maybe like this, the yellow thumbs up you can see on my screen, I think. Yeah, so you can show me like this or like this. If you have any doubt, any question, please use your fingers, type and ask me on a chat box. I will try my best to answer everyone's question, but as you all can see, it's a large group, so maybe I can miss out some questions. So I'm so sorry in advance, but I will try my best to answer everyone's question. And right now I'm receiving so many doubts, so many questions regarding compass and papers and everything. So quickly, let's start without wasting any time. So before I start, I always share a little sample. And for today's work, what we are going to do? Paper balls. So how we can use that? Of course, in a decoration, it's a decorative item, yeah. And we can make it in very different colors. And of course, I have written over there the material list that you can use colored sheet or you can use old newspaper. And I will request if you have colored sheet and newspaper both. So please prefer newspaper first because it is your first attempt. And I really want that what are mistakes you are going to do. Let's do it roughly. First learn and then apply on a colored sheet. But if you don't have newspaper, if you have only colored sheet, so dear everyone, you need a lot of colored sheet, at least 25 A4 colored sheet. If you want, you can use same color or you can use different color sheet. It's totally up to you. When I'm going to show you the result, when I'm going to show you the sample, I think that is much more easy to understand. So right now I'm going to do all the work on my newspaper, rough newspaper, okay, old newspaper. So I'm going to use old newspaper and I will prefer, please everyone, it's a request, you also use newspaper, okay, that is much more easier. Let's learn first and then you can apply the techniques for your colored sheet, okay. So what we are going to make today? This. Now what is this? Half circle? No. Can you tell me? Can anybody guess what is this? Actually, we are going to learn today this. Ah, there's a surprise. You don't know? Manav, you don't know? Okay. Yes, ball. But it is not looking like a ball. Don't you think? Yeah, paper. It is not looking like a paper ball, but it is. How? There's a surprise. See. Don't you think it's beautiful? Yeah? Who like this? See, you can show me thumbs up. You can write on a chat box. Who? Please, those who are really very excited to learn how to make paper ball. And you can see, I have used newspaper for this. You can use colored sheet. Of course, I think now it's clear. So, see. Lovely, don't you think? And we can tie a thread over here and we can hang it. We can make it in a different size. Yeah, even shapes. So it's a beautiful, beautiful decorative item with very simple steps if you are going to concentrate. Okay, so let's start without wasting any time. And you can see, you can close it, you can open it. It means whenever you want to decorate, go ahead, just paste and decorate, hang it or keep it somewhere. And when you don't want to decorate or you want to keep it somewhere, then unfold it and easy. Yeah. So let's start without wasting any time. First of all, I'm going to tell you about material, what exactly we need. And right now I am receiving that I don't have compass. How many newspaper you need, I will give you all the answers. So don't worry. Okay, so just give me a second. I have to fix my phone. I have lots of queries. Wonderful. Questions are always beautiful. You should ask questions and I'm going to give you answers. So don't worry. Just give me a second. Okay, so here we go. As you can see, only these simple material you need for making paper balls. And the solution, those who are not having compass, those who are having compass, that is perfectly fine. Okay, and please use compass. But those who are not have compass, you can use this size of plate or bowl or whatever circular object you have. Okay, so you can see the size. It is, I think, a little bigger from my hand. And this size, I think it's available with everyone. It can be a little small also, that is also perfectly fine. A little big also, okay, no problem. But at least this size you need so that you can have a beautiful result. Okay, you can see if you want this size of ball, so you need this circle, this much big circle. Okay, so you can use any object. I think it's clear. Those who are not having compass, please observe. It will improve your observation power also. Please look around you. I'm sure that you are going to have some object in a circular. Okay, so please use that. You need scissor, glue. Those who are having these kind of glue, means the pointed one, the cone one, please use that, prefer that. Those who are don't have the cone, this thing, those, maybe many of you are going to use that stick, glue stick, that is also perfectly fine. So whatever glue you have, that is perfectly fine. I'm going to use this cone one. Okay, and you need newspaper. Okay, so many questions. How many newspaper we need for this craft? You need total 25 circles of this size. 25 circle of this size. 25 circles. Okay, so it means we are using rough old newspaper. So I am sure that if you don't have get 25 circle with one newspaper, maybe you can use another one. Okay, so maybe two or three newspaper is enough. I think two is more than enough. If your size, plate size or whatever object you are going to use, it's bigger, then of course you need a bigger, more and more newspaper. Okay, I'm going to use, I think, one sheet, one paper is enough for my size of plate. Okay, I don't have newspaper, someone has written. If you don't have newspaper, please try whatever sheet you have. You can use magazine sheets also. If you have old magazines, or if you have colored sheet or colored chart paper, please use that also. Okay, the size of, you can see, and we need 25 circles, so it means 25 sheets you need. Okay, so it's easy to use newspaper. You need one rough sheet. One rough sheet. Yes, you can use any sheet. Please try to understand. So many questions regarding sheets. And I'm repeating myself again and again, same thing. Now I'm going to repeat it last time. Please concentrate. Okay, so whatever sheet you have, you can use that newspaper or any colored sheet, any sheet and any color sheet. It means if you don't have colored sheet, you can use white sheet also. Okay, I hope now it's clear. And you need one rough sheet. You can see this is my rough sheet, one side plain and one side. So you can use even newspaper. Okay, so let's start. I will tell you the measurement, those who are using compass, and you need ruler also, pencil and eraser. As I always do, I always use my sketch pen for all the drawings. So I'm going to use the same. So first of all, we need to make 25 circles. We are going to make and cut. We are going to draw and cut. But I will tell you shortcut so that we can have same size circle in one time. What we can do, we have these folded newspapers now. Do not unfold it because of these folds, you can see these layers. And when we are going to draw and cut, with these layers, we can get same size circles. Many circles in same time, okay? So I'm not going to unfold this newspaper. I'm going to just make my circles. And if you don't want to waste even your newspaper also, you can take plate, which is a little smaller, so that you can arrange two circles maybe in one newspaper. I think that is also good. So just keep your circle object, and I'm going to tell you the measurement of those who are using compass. It is around, you can fix your compass around 8 or 9 centimeter. Okay, just fix your compass 8 or 9 centimeter, and when you are going to make that circle, it is about 16 or 18 centimeter total. Okay, so you have to fix your compass around 8 or 9 centimeter. And now I'm not going to unfold my sheet, my newspaper, going to make it. So let's start. Just draw, make an outline. Both are okay. 25 sheets, ma'am, yes. 25 sheets if you are using sheets. It means you need 25 circles. And if you can get two circles from one sheet, that is much more good. Okay, so try to use sheet. Do not waste it. Okay, so if you can get more circles from one sheet, I think two circles from one sheet is better. So after making this circle, and please, if you're not comfortable with cutting part, please take help. And we cannot do everything in 1 hour. Right now, please try to learn only, okay? So after making this drawing, I'm going to cut. And we need really sharp cut. So please take help if you need. I'm okay with that. Take help if you have thick layer of sheets. So this one is the technique. When you get much more circles in one time, and I think that's a smart work. So we are going to do smart work also. We have to do, okay? So just, and those who are using sheet, and those who are planning two circles in one sheet or one circle in one sheet, please use layers. Take two or three, four, five sheets, whatever it suits you, and cut together so that you can get many more circles of same size, just like this. You can see, I'm going to show you. See, because of layers, I have so many sheets right now, circles right now, same size, and see. Don't you think it's good? Yes. Okay, so if your circle is much more bigger, see, mine is bigger. I think it is not coming on my this sheet. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take another paper. Okay. And before that, I'm going to count my circles first so that I can cut according to that. 16 circles I have right now. So it means I need more circles. I will request you all, those who need time for cutting 25 circles, please cut at least 10. 10 circles at least. You can continue with next step with those 10 circles. And when you are done with all the steps, I'm sure when you are going to learn the concept, it is much more easy to understand. And you can continue your work after the class also. So if you are able to cut 25 circles, perfectly fine. And if you need more time, please cut at least minimum 10 circles right now. Learn all the steps. And after the class, you can continue with your 25 left circles, okay? Lakshit, I can see you're ready with your circles. It's amazing. Wow, very good. Very nice speed also. I am impressed. Those who are having 12, 10 sheets, those are not having, those who are using sheets, and if you don't have enough sheet, means 25 sheet, I already told you, please try to make two circles in one sheet, just like this, just fold your sheet, those who are using A4, and use this area. You will get two circles in one sheet, okay? And if you need more, then whenever you are ready with your 25 sheets, you can continue. Right now, whatever circles, whatever quantity you have, try to learn with that, okay? You can add more circles. Okay, so now again, we need same size. Just remember this, it is very important. Same size circle. 25 circles, okay? I am going to do all the steps again. I'm not going to unfold my newspaper so that I will get more circles in one time. I'm going to cut it slowly so that I can get beautiful sharp cut, which is very important if you really want good result, okay? Those who are struggling with your circles, please take help. Please take help. Maximum you need 25 for this class, and minimum please be ready with at least 10. And after this class, you can add more. Lavanya, you have to be patient, okay? Everyone is still doing, so we have to give time to everyone. If you are ready with your 25 circles, it's wonderful, dear. But please wait for others also. It's a teamwork. Come on. Okay, thank you so much for your support. So here we go. I'm ready with my circles right now. You can see same size. I have did it. Wonderful. Great. Very good speed. Done. Arush. Oh my God. Great. Wonderful. Lidu and Rishi. Very good, dear. Okay. Ma'am, we can use 12 circles. Yes, you can use. Okay, just for learning process. And after this class, you can add more circles. Okay, let's learn. When I'm going to tell you next, second or third step, then I think it is easy to understand why I'm telling you that at least start with 10 or 12 circles. Okay. So I hope everyone is ready. Now, after every step, I'm going to give you time. So I'm going to give you a few seconds. I have done without help. Oh, wow. Wonderful. Great. Those who are taking help, that is also wonderful. 24 circles. That is also perfectly fine if you have 24 circles. Ma'am, I have 16. Perfect. Perfect. See, there is one more thing which you have to understand. If you are using this size, which I have used, then you need 25 circles. And if you are using smaller one, you need less quantity. Okay, just try to understand that. But if you cut 25 circles, small circles, then no problem, you can make two balls. Okay, maybe two balls, then it's a wonderful thing. But if you are using this size, you need 25. If you are using smaller one, you need less circle quantity. Okay. Okay, so let's start. I think everyone is ready. Okay, Kriti. 18 circles, perfectly fine. Okay, so we have to match. We have to manage time also. So let's start because all the steps are a little lengthy and a little tricky also. So now after cutting these circles, whatever circles you have right now, please now stop cutting. I think you have at least 10 or 12 circles till now. So please, that is enough. Now please start with another step. So take your rough sheet, whatever sheet you are going to use, that is perfectly fine. Rough sheet, okay? You need your scale and your pencil and eraser. But before this step, very simple step we need to do. Take your circle and fold it from the center. Take your circle, fold it from the center. Take your circle, fold it from the center. You have to do the same step with all your circles. So hurry up, come on, do it fast. We all are doing craft and I think most of you have already attended so many classes of mine. And now I hope you all are masters. Huh? So please speed up, come on. In craft, we have to learn how to handle paper. So do it fast. Come on. You can take three circles together also. See, just like this. Three circles I'm taking. Keeping equally and just fold. Give a sharp fold, which is very important from the center only. And see, together. I have done three circles. So please use this technique. It will help you. Okay. Take your circle again. fold it from the center, and you will get again more and more circles. Take circles. I'm taking circles. Why I'm telling circles, not circle? Because see, so many circles I'm taking right now and just folding together. And it's done. Again, do it fast. Come on, come on. Everyone, you all can do it. It's a very easy step. Don't you think? We have to just fold it. Show me your skills fast. Okay, great. I hope you all are ready with your half circles now, the folded ones. Now what we need to do, take your rough sheet, your scale and your pencil. Take your one circle and we have to keep it like this on your sheet. Okay. Can I use six? Yes, you can. The concept is you have to learn first. Okay. When you have learned all the steps, you can add more circles on it. If you are comfortable with six circles, that is perfectly fine. Okay. Now what we need to do, I'm going to make point over here and over here, the end of my circles. Just like this. See, dot. Two dots you can see over here and here. So I'm going to make a line. The size of my half circle. So this measurement is very important. Just keep your circle, half circle like this, the folded one, and mark it, the end, mark the ends. Now, join both the lines or dot, whatever you have made, like this. Join. Shamiksha, please, dear, concentrate. You are asking me the same question which I have repeated so many times. Yes, you can use newspaper if you don't have sheets, okay? Okay, let's start. Now what we need to do, I'm going to make line at the end like this. And now I'm going to take my scale and going to make line. Just try to maintain the distance as I'm using my scale only to maintain the distance so that there will be no confusion. I have this extra part, but that is perfectly fine if you are also getting this. If you have these perfect distance lines, but you have the ending point like this, that is perfectly fine. So don't worry about that. According to my size of circle, I have right now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 lines. Maybe if you have the small circles or maybe the bigger one, maybe you have more or less lines, that is also perfectly fine. Okay, it is going to according to your circle. So according to my circle, I have this much of line. 7, perfectly fine. 7, 8, 9, 10, 4, 5, that is perfectly fine, whatever you are getting. Okay. Okay, let's start with another step. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to mark it with alphabet and numbers. Please try to understand first. 1, this is called number, 1, 2, 3, and alphabets A, B, C, D. Yes? So 1 is going to be 1 first line and second line is going to be A. Then again one A. It means I'm going to use number, then alphabet, then number, then alphabet. You can use any alphabet or any number. That is perfectly fine. But the thing should be like this. Alphabet, one should be alphabet, another one should be number. Okay? Okay, I think now it's done. I have left this last line. So please leave this one if you are going to have this extra line. So leave it, do not mark it, okay? Now what we need to do, please. Now it's very important, very, very, very important step now I'm going to tell you. So be ready with your circles, the half folded ones. See, these are the folded circles now. And be ready with your glue. Very important step. Now what we need to do, I'm going to keep my circle like this. Actually, it's right now I'm calling it half circle, okay? Just keep it on this baseline. This is, I'm calling it baseline. This line, I'm calling baseline, okay? Baseline, I'm going to keep it like this. Now open your circle like this only. Just keep it like this. Carefully open it. You can see the crease line over here. Because of fold, you will get crease line on the center of your circle. Okay, just try to observe first whatever I am telling you. Then start. I'm going to repeat it again. Take your half circle, keep it on a baseline. Now open your circle like this. Please look your crease line which you have on your center of your circle. Now what we need to do, now I'm going to take my glue and going to continue my second line, it means alphabet line, like this. There is no need to start right now. Just observe first. I have started, just try to continue this line till my crease line. It means the center of my circle. Till here, not till here. No, not the end of your circle. No, 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 big no. Till this crease line. Now, because I have started with my alphabet, it means I have to continue making line only of my alphabet's line, like this. I'm going to leave my number line and going to continue my alphabet. Right now, please try to understand first. This is your first step. Number, alphabet A, alphabet A, alphabet A. And I have left these number one line. Okay. Now I'm going to close my circle as it is. Not going to press a lot. No, there's no need to press it hard. Just keep your hand slowly, nicely. Okay. And now what we need to do, I have started with alphabet. Now I am going to continue with my number line. The same process. Continue number. Continue number. 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 Now what to do? Now take your another circle. Half circle. Keep it like this. Okay, do it slowly, let it paste. Now, because I have used second one, second circle, now again I'm going to open it. Open your second circle, because previous one we have done number, now again I'm going to start with alphabet. It means one time you need to do alphabet, another time you have to continue with number, alphabet number, alphabet number. And if you by chance forget that whatever you have done, so by chance I have no clue what I have done in last previous step, then you can take your circle, open a little bit, then you can have this patch of your glue. It means I have started with alphabet. It means time to start with number. It's a little tricky, but if you are going to observe, it will really improve your observation and concentration power, and both are very important for any artist. Okay, so try to observe and concentrate. One time you have to start with alphabet, second time you have to do number. When you are done with this, take your another circle, keep it like this, and open your circle. Then if you are done with your number, then it means you have to start with alphabet, continue with alphabet, close your circle and continue with your number. Now take your another circle, keep it perfectly. It should be perfect, huh? So keep it slowly. Now after keeping it, open it, because we have done numbers. So now I'm going to start with alphabet. Now just like this, you have to do all the circles, all the 25 circles like this only. Okay, if you forget, just you can remove a little bit, check whatever you have done. I have done alphabet, it means I have to do my number lines now. Take your circle and then again open it. Now alphabet. Number. Just like this only. And I am not receiving right now any question. It's wonderful. It means everyone, you all are doing wonderful job. Yeah. So thank you so much for your support, actually. Thank you so much. So now, after number, continue with alphabet, then and again number, then alphabet, and add. Keep adding your circle. Open, close, add. Open, close, add. Just try to concentrate. Then I'm sure you are not going to make any mistake. But if you made a mistake, no problem. Now you know what to do. You can do it again. So don't worry, okay? That's why I always tell you that first learn, try to learn. And if you learn something, you can make it again and again and again. Okay? So like this only, you have to continue with all 25 steps. See, all 25 steps. So those who are using 10 circles, 12 circles, 25 circles, whatever number, I'm going to repeat very important point that if you are using same size of circle, which I am using, you need 25 circles, okay? And if you are using small or bigger size, then maybe you need according to your size. It means if you are using smaller circle, you need less circles then, okay? Not 25, I think then half of number is enough. And if you are using the bigger one, then you need more, okay? So after all the 25 circles, when you are ready with all the pasting work, maybe you can open it a little bit. I know that it is not dry yet, but you can open it so that you can understand that you are doing right or wrong. Just open it slowly. Do not give any pressure. You can see this effect. If you are getting this effect, I think you are doing wonderful job then, okay? So I'm going to give you a little time. If you have any confusion, any doubt regarding this step, please ask. Otherwise, I can see all of you are doing wonderful job, very busy right now. It is very good. Okay, Lavanya, you did not, okay. No problem. Please look here. I hope this is clear. One baseline, which should be according to your circle size, like this, from here to here, you can see the same size. Yes, this baseline. Now what we need to do, I'm going to tell you everything again. So if you have, if anyone having problem, please look here. So you need to take your circle, make a baseline. I'm calling this line as a baseline. It should be size of your circle. You can see the same size. Now I have used my scale and made these lines. You can see the distance are same. Okay. This extra line, just if you are getting this extra line, leave it as it is. And I have this much of line, maybe you have more or less. It should be according to your circle. It is going to according to your circle. So that is perfectly fine. Now what I have done, I have written number one in the first line, then A alphabet, then number alphabet, number alphabet number. Okay. Okay, now what we need to do, take your first circle, this folded one, okay? Keep it on a baseline like this. Open your circle as it is, just keeping on your baseline only. After opening, you will get this crease line because of fold. Take your glue and continue making your alphabet line like this with your glue till your crease line only. Leave number because we have started with alphabet. Alphabet, alphabet. After this, close your circle because we have done with alphabet. Now it means we have to start with number because we have done alphabet. Now second time we have to do number. Continue with making number lines. Take your circle, the another one, keep it into it. Now open. Now because we have done number, now it means it's turn of alphabet. So like this only, alphabet, then again number, alphabet, number, and try. Keep adding your circles. Okay, after adding all the circles, whatever you are done with that. So you, when you are going to open it, okay, I have received one question that how to open it. So let it dry first, which is very important, okay? If you really want to see the result, let it dry. But if you, I'm sure that you have so much of excitement that you want to see the effect. So just take your circle like this and open it with very gentle hand, okay? See, you can see if you are getting this effect, it means you are doing your job wonderfully. Okay? See, and after pasting all the 25 or whatever circles you have done, you will get this effect. Those who after pasting it, those who are confused that you need more circles, please add more. if you understand, if you think that this much circle is not enough. See why? Because how to make it into a ball? Just do it like this, and you will get this ball. Just apply glue over here, paste it like this, and you will get this. If you don't have glue, you can, if you don't want to use glue, because if you are going to use glue for this area, it is going to be permanent, okay? So if you want that, you don't want to make it permanently, just stapler it. Stapler, I hope everyone knows what is a stapler. So just use stapler so that you, when you don't want to decorate it, you can remove that stapler pins and it will again unfold. Okay. Okay. So after making this circle, if your circle is not joining like this, if it is not coming like this, it means you need to add more circles. It's a sign. It means you need more circles. So please add more. And if your circle is both the sides are joining like this and you are getting this beautiful circle, it means it's perfect. And if it is not coming like this, if it is not joining like this, please add more. Okay. Any doubt? I think it's done. I hope you have understood. I use stapler. Okay. Please use stapler. I think it's the best option so that you can remove your that pins if you don't want to decorate it, if you want to keep it, if you want to if you are going somewhere for a party or maybe something, so maybe you, if you want to carry these balls, it's comfortable to carry like this. Now ma'am, how to open? Just take both the sides and open it, and I will suggest let it dry first. Okay, let it dry first, then open. And if you really want to see effect, if you don't have patience, then open it slowly, very with very gentle hand. If you are getting this much of effect, that is perfectly fine. Leave it for some time so that it will stick, will dry, and then you can open like this and join both the circles. Apply glue over here and just open and join. And if it is not coming like this, it means you need to add more circles. I don't get that design. It means you have done some mistakes. Please try again. Okay. Please try again, or maybe we are going to share the video also, class video. It will help you, so don't worry. Okay, and I'm sure that you have done this much correctly. So what you need to do, this step is you have to continue these lines. So first you have to continue with alphabet, then you have to continue with number. Simple. Okay, so don't worry if you are not getting the same result. That's why I have told you in the beginning that please use newspaper. Okay, so that whatever mistakes you are going to get, we are not going to waste sheets, but perfectly fine. Okay. So now I'm going to see everyone's work. So whatever you have done, I'm really excited right now. It's difficult to take everyone's name, but I'm sure that you all have done a wonderful job. Many of you are still doing great. Wonderful. Take your time. There is no need to hurry. Take your time. Okay, you all are doing wonderful job. So clapping for you all. And you can also clap for yourself. Okay, you all have done wonderful job. And I can see you all are still doing great. Okay, where you need to use stapler. Yeah, it's very simple. I have so many queries that how to join both the circles. See, this is after pasting, you will get this. Okay, you will get this. Now what we need to do, we need to paste both the sides. We need to paste or stapler both the sides. Now open it, join, get it together. If it is not getting together, it means you need to add more circles. Please cut more circles, paste the same way, and you will get this. Okay, after joining both the sides, stapler or use your glue, whatever you want. Okay, then you will get this. Now if you want to place it somewhere, place it. If you want to hang it, please add thread over here and hang it. Please use different size and color. Try to make with different size and colors. Those who are using colored sheets right now, it's perfectly fine. I think you are going to get a beautiful result. Those who are using these newspaper, I think it is also looking beautiful. Yes. So please use, try to use with colored sheet if you have, with the different size of circles, and you can use different shapes also with same technique. Okay. So I hope you like the class. Yes, please show me thumbs up, or you can write on a chat box, please. Okay, Sameeksha, no doubts, you have explained. Oh, thank you so much for this appreciation. I always try this. Okay, great, wow, okay, lovely. It means today your house is going to be look lovely, huh? Great, please use this skill. It's a beautiful way to decorate your garden, or maybe your living place, or maybe a corner of your house. And if you are going to use lights, which we call jhalar lights, okay, which we use generally use in Diwali or for decoration or everything. So you can, if you are going to use that around it, it will look lovely. Okay, so try to use different things and try to decorate it more. You can paste, after making this ball, you can paste beautiful handcraft flowers. You can paste it like this over here. So it will look beautiful. Yeah. So I hope you like the class, and lovely, lovely, lovely students are clapping for you all. And you can please clap for yourself. Let's celebrate this moment because you have learned something new. Yes, lovely, great. So over to you, ma'am. I'm done.